Hello and welcome to the physical chemistry of Dr. Laut. My task is, what is the effect on the EMF of the cell shown in figure 20.5? Which has the overall reaction? Zinc plus Cooper raised to the exponent 2 plus reacts to Cooper plus zinc raised to the exponent 2 plus. For each of the following change, A. Zinc chloride is added to the anode half cell. B. Cooper chloride is added to the anode half cell. C. The surface area of the anode is cut to half. D. The cell operates for 1 hour. 2A. The most important factor in cell EMF is the concentration of ions in each cell. If the concentration of one cell is lower, then more of the solid will dissolve out, taking or releasing electrons as needed. In this case, the concentration of zinc chloride is increased, and thus the reaction equilibrium. Zinc reacts to zinc raised to the exponent 2 plus 2 electrons minus is now pushed back towards the reactants. Thus, it can be seen that less electrons will be liberated. Because of this, the EMF or electromotive force of the cell will be reduced. For a mathematical view, slightly more complicated way of explaining this, we can look at the equation for determining the EMF of a cell. Potential of a half cell is equal to Standardpotential minus gas constant times temperature divided by number of remaining electron times Faraday constant times natural logarithm of reaction coefficient. The value we care about is the Q, or the ratio between the two ions. Potential of a half cell is equal to 1.10 volts minus 0.0592 volts divided by 2 times decadal logarithm times zinc raised to the exponent 2 plus divided by Cooper raised to the exponent 2 plus. As we can see, if we increase the concentration of zinc ions, we end up subtracting a larger number from the standard equilibrium EMF, thus leading to an overall lower reading of the voltmeter. B. The addition of Cooper chloride ions to the unknown causes both of the reduction and oxidation reactions to occur in the same beaker with equines Cooper ions taking 2 electrons from the solid zinc, then the depositing itself of the surface. Because less electrons are now forced to travel through the voltmeter in order to complete the redox reaction, it will show a lower reading, C. Even when the surface area is smaller, it is important to note that the same components are present and in the same concentrations, thus from the equations in part A. It can be seen that the EMF measured by the voltmeter will be the same in the both cases. D. After operating for 1 hour, the salt bridge will be starting to dry out and run out of ions. Missouri to keep each beaker. Net will in change. Once this happens, change begins to build up and the electrons stop flowing between the beakers. The voltmeter will read 0 volt as if the circuit were open.